Hello students, now we are going to see need of biasing in BJT. First of all, the question in your mind is that what is need of biasing in BJT? So the reason is that in BJT we want Q point to be stable. Stable means exactly at the middle of the load line, but there is variation in the Q point due to temperature and other regions and other reasons. So let's see that. So need of biasing can be classified in two things. The first thing is position of Q point, and the second point is variation in IC, that is collector current, with respect to beta, VBE and temperature. So these are two important points because of which we go for biasing in BJT. Let's start with first point, position of Q point. Normally, what we do is we select Q point exactly at the middle of the load line as shown in the figure. Now, if we select Q point above this or below this, then there can be clip off or clipping can be seen. That means the output waveform is not exactly identical. To get output exactly identical in positive half and negative half, we want Q point to be there at the center of the load line, and this is the first reason why we are going for biasing of BJT. The second point was variation in IC. Now first of all, we will clear that Q point is nothing but IC and VCE, where IC plotted on the Y axis and VCE plotted on the X axis. So I'll write that Q point is nothing but all possible values of VCE and corresponding values of IC. Now we want Q point to be stable. For that, VCE and IC both must be stable. Are you getting this? I want Q point to be stable. For that, VCE and IC must have stable values, but IC is a function of temperature, beta and VBE. So as temperature, beta or VBE is changing, IC will change. If IC changes, Q point will change, and hence we are going to stabilize IC to get stable Q point. This is the second reason why we are biasing BJT. Now let's see in detail. The first point is temperature. Let PIDC is nothing but input DC power, which is given by power supply or DC source, which can be written as VCC into IC. Let's equation 1. PIDC is nothing but power supplied to the transistor by external source, external DC source, whose value is given as VCC into IC. Now let's PQ is power of transistor, power across transistor, which is given as VCE into IC. But our Q point is at the center of the load line, hence VCE is nothing but VCC by 2. So equation will become PQ is nothing but VCC divided by 2 into IC, which is nothing but 50% of PIDC, where PQ is power drop across transistor, which is equal to 50% that of supplied power. This is equation number 2. From equation 2, it is clear that whatever power is supplied, out of that 50% is drop across transistor, because of which temperature across transistor will increase. Hence, we can write that temperature increases. As temperature increases, IC minority will increase. This is minority current from collector. We know that IC is equal to IC minority plus IC majority. And hence, ultimately, because of increment in the temperature, IC will increase. As IC is increasing, power drop across transistor, which is a function of IC, will increase. And hence, we can write that PQ is increasing. As PQ is increasing, temperature will increase. Temperature increases, IC increases. IC increases, PQ increases. And this process will become cyclic. In cyclic, what will happen is, first, temperature across transistor will increase. That is the first point. Because of that, IC will increase. And again, temperature will increase. Power drop will increase. This process will become cyclic. And at the end, our transistor will get damaged because of this. And hence, we need to bias BJT against temperature variation. Now, the second point is IC variation against beta. We know that IC, that is collector current, is equal to beta times of base current. Collector current is always equal to beta times that of base current. Now, this beta is device parameter. We will write that beta is device parameter. This means that beta depends upon device to device. If we change the device, beta will change, and hence IC will change. Are you getting this point? Whenever we are going to change a particular transistor, a transistor is replaced by another transistor. In that particular case, value of beta will be different, and hence value of IC will change. This is the second reason why we need to bias BJT. So throughout designing, we must keep same transistor so that variation of IC against beta can be controlled. And the third point is IC variation against cut-in voltage or VBE. Now, cut-in voltage decreases. That means VBE decreases with temperature. With temperature. By 2.5 millivolts per degree Celsius. For every change of 1 degree Celsius, the cut-in voltage decreases by 2.5 millivolts. Because of this, IB will decrease and hence IC will decrease. As IC is changing, Q point will change. Are you getting this point? Because of VBE is changing, IB is decreasing. Because of that, IC is decreasing. And Q point is not stable. To avoid all these things, we need to bias BJT so that Q point variation will be in control. That means value of VCE and IC remain constant. This is need of biasing in BJT. Thank you.